Hello, hello. Welcome back to Tactics Ogre. Let us cling together. Wow, that was bad. One vision mod. We're in the Palace of the Dead, still, and we're on level 65. But if you'll remember from last episode, level 65 is a shop with a funny little pumpkin boy. If you'll remember, the first shop actually had a skeleton, so... I'm glad they changed that. They didn't make it so that you could hire, like, undead people from here, which would make the most sense, but... I don't know what Danelle's doing in the 65th floor. Maybe it's like magic, I don't know. Whatever. Anyway. So, just like last time, we're gonna do something special for this stupid little, silly little floor. Let's get on to it. You might recognize this. This is a freaking tier list. So, what do we need to do with the tier list? You tier stuff on it, dummy. Well, I'm just going to tier units based on how useful they've been in my army so far. This is my unprofessional opinion of these silly little goobers. Again, I'm not a pro gamer, even though you might seem like it sometimes. Definitely, I don't get paid for my gaming, which I honestly should, but this is a dumb conversation. Anyway, first unit. Denim jacket. Little bitty itty bitty denim. He's pretty good. He dies. I have him in Berserker right now, so he kind of dies real early. So he does do a shit ton of damage. Definitely the most single target damage I can do to one unit at a single time. Like consistently over 300 damage on a squishier unit. And definitely more if it's against an undead right now because he has undead infective stuff. So I think he was pushing over like 400 damage to a single, like close to 500 damage on some of those undead dragons earlier, which was crazy with no finisher and no buffs. So that's pretty crazy. I'm gonna put him in A right now. I should have planned this out ahead of time. I'm gonna just go with gut feeling with A right now. We'll see. By the way, in the tiers, I'm not gonna do any orders right now, mostly because I have to do this in OBS and it's really hard. Hold on, let me turn off Tactics Ogre because it's in the background, because you can't hear it, but I can, and it's getting annoying. Anyway, that's pretty cool right now. The next unit on the list, I shouldn't have done that, I closed it, but is Reinhold. Should I move it around like this and make it as distracting as possible? So Reinhold right here, he's really, really tanky. He's like a slightly less tanky, slightly more powerful version of Voltaire, which I think that has to do with him being a warrior and him being in the class. He doesn't do as much damage. I don't think his weapon is as useful as Voltaire's is for supporting enemies, but I think they're about on the same list as usefulness. I think I've seen him die in a while, just because of how little damage the warriors take. So he's pretty good. I'm gonna put him in B tier simply because he can't output enough damage to be useful, but like holy crap, if you need a wall, then damn, dude. You know what? I'm gonna put him in, I feel bad, maybe low, you were definitely in low B tier for now. But anyway, okay. Next up is Pulmia. Pulmia is now a Fusilier, which is a very good class. They did buff it in the last patch where they now take less RT to do their finishers, so that's really good. But and they also got like a new instead of barricade, they got the grenade that inflicts debuffs on enemy mages, which is pretty good, and they also have access to grenades, which is really good. I think that's enough. I think grenade access is honestly enough to bump her up to B tier. The grenades are just so good for spreading. Like it's just like a 100% chance to inflict any, like either paralyze, poison, or silence on a group of five enemies, up to five enemies in a cross. That's just so good. That's enough to put you up to B tier, honestly, in my opinion. As far as damage output goes, she dies. She's very, very squishy, of course. She doesn't have a lot of dodge, which definitely put her down to C tier, honestly. Even though her damage output is pretty good, her RT is pretty bad. Is probably the worst among every character. I think she is the worst RT. cost for her weapon for, like, damage that she's probably in. I think she has the highest range damage, but not compared to Aurelia's range damage. It's not that much more compared to how much RT it is. But grenades will put her up to B tier, at least. And then her squishiness and dodginess are bad, so that's why she's not at A tier. So next unit, I really should not have close tactics Ogre, because I'm going to struggle with which unit is next. But the next unit over here is Bardolf. Bardolf's gotten better. He has gotten better with his ranks, but I'm going to put him on down to D tier, I think, right now, just on gut feeling. Let's shrink him a little bit. I'm probably going to shrink units as I go on, but anyway. Bardolf is a little bit shrinked. I don't know why I said a little bit shrinked. Sorry, I got to get distracted by a text. That's why I can't speak. So, Bardolf right here. Absolute shit magic damage right now. Like, it's garbage compared to some of my other, like, mage units that are real bad. Yeah, I get, like, the necromancy is not useful. I imagine I'm not sure if you can have an undead necromancer, actually, which would be incredibly insane. But, a necromancer with an undead army would actually be really great. But unfortunately, I did not do an undead army, so I can't really test that out. So as far as his usefulness in this army goes, as bad. He is putting decent damage with his crossbow right now, but, you know, not the best. Definitely not as good as Sarah. He says shit hit. Araman's pretty good, but you know, and he is like basic healer utility. He is basic, like, exorcism utility if he's close enough, but it's really rudimentary. And then he has the special where he can, like, instantly banish undead, but I've got it hit once so far, and not great. I think he'll maybe rise to, like, low C tier as soon as he gets better, like, crossbow utility, but as far as, like, note right now, he's a D. I really should probably change him to a lich, but, you know, I just feel, I don't want to look at his freaking ugly face. Like, maybe if it was a girl that I got, I would change them to a lich, because at least they cover it up, but, you know, it's just not great. Okay, next unit on our list is, oh god, is it? Okay, I'm gonna open up Tactics Ogre again, I apologize for that. I can honestly mute it. And then, you guys can't hear this, but... Okay, stop zooming. Okay. Please go to party menu. Okay, next unit on our list is Rosa. Let's find her on the list. Rosa. I have a lot of PNGs in this folder. I really should have sorted them. Or at least, like, kind of memorized. Okay, there she is. Here's a witch. Okay, right now she's a witch. I'm gonna put her... Should she go in D tier? I mean, she's not that bad. She can heal a unit. She would definitely be low C tier, I think, if I were to order on the this tier list. I'm not going to, but if they're in the same tier, then just know they're not exactly ordered in tiers. But as far as she goes, right now, I think what my plan for her is going to be, I'm not going to spoil it, I guess, but she's going to be a lot better once that plan gets going, but that's not going to be till post game. So we'll figure that out when we get there. I might even go ahead and do, like, some of that post game stuff unfilmed so I can immediately get that. But for right now, I'm just kind of stuck in the Palace of the Dead, so I can't really go do that. I can't go, like, beat the game and then go grab that and warp back to the Palace of the Dead. That would be kind of anachronous, so. Anyway, I might go do that and then say, hey, look what I got. I got something cool. And then you'll see that. But anyway, right now, she can, like, heal other units' MP. She's not as good of a warlock, of a witch, as Rudlum. She can do decent light damage. I think she's, like, rank 4 light, which is really good. But rank 4 light is not enough to do decent damage as, like, a generic witch with no... It's enough to do decent damage, but it's not enough to do, like, great damage with the area specials. Anyway, she does miss more often than Kasha does with her Draconic Light spell, the Aura spell, which is why I think I'm going to put her here. So, she, like, that miss chance and stuff. And she's, like, she just got rank 2 katanas, I think, so that's not good either. But we'll see. Maybe she'll get better. I do have a really cool plan for her as far as katanas go as well, which is why I'm training katanas on her as well as Rudlum. Okay, anyway, next unit is Bertrand. I think he would be a medium C tier, probably. Let's go. I haven't been using his item ability as much as I should, or his summon utility. I mean, summon utility isn't great because mostly he can't do damage, but I really should check that more often, honestly. But the fact he can use summons is really great, honestly. But if he gets enough magic, if I spent enough cards on him, that might be really, really good. But, you know, unfortunately, I can't do it now. Anyway, I think his spears are okay. They're fine. Fire is fine. Magic's not good, but you know, I never use that anyway, so it doesn't matter. And he can use occasional item utility I have on him, so I can use him as like an off healer. So like I kind of use Adelaida for as my main healer, but I think a light based rune fencer would have been better because of the dispel utility that they have, but. I could not have planned for that this far ahead. Like, that's just something. I think I actually chose fire. I don't think he started with that. He definitely started with spears, but I didn't choose fire for him. So I did choose fire for him. Excuse me, the game didn't choose fire for him. But maybe I would have chosen a different element if I had known that ahead of time what all the elements did. But that was like 5 months ago, so can't yell at me for that. That was literally 5 months ago. I'm recording exactly 5 months from when I recorded the first episodes. I just realized so. Well, I didn't just realize I looked up that later, like earlier today. I looked at all the old recordings. Anyway, let's move on from this. Again, according, they're not ordered in tiers because it's hard to grab them. See, if I tried to grab, I can actually grab it. Okay, well, I don't want to do it anyway. It's kind of a pain to stack them on top of each other because they're not like locked in. Because I'm not doing this on tierlist.org because I didn't want to make an account upload like a bunch of images to it and do all that. They're not a hassle. Anyway, who's the next unit? The next unit is... get back to tier list. Canopus. Canopus is pretty freaking good. I don't think I'm training him correctly. I'm gonna put him in... Yeah, I think the flying around utility is really good. I think I maybe should have gone axes as far as his secondary weapon goes. Like, him flying around with a bow and an axe would have been a little bit better. But I think the spear is working pretty fine. Yeah, he definitely deserves an A tier for, like, his flying utility. He is a little squishy. He does go down a lot, but that's because I'm bad at the game. I think if I was using him to his fullest potential, maybe also giving him, like, whatever that stack is, wind shot. I keep forgetting to put that back on him. That thing that does void damage in a line. I think that might be good, but for right now, you're just casting water spells. I did that because I think the highest one-handed spear is a water spear, so that's why I did that specifically. But I know, like, canon, he's called the Wind Caller. You should probably, like, call him the Wind. Put him in, like, Wind class. But that's neither here nor there. Anyway, next freaking unit is... Big D! Where the hell is Big D? There he is. Denalto. I'm gonna put him solid. I mean, healers. I think just if you're a dedicated healer, you definitely probably should get put in A tier. Let me move everybody to the side a little bit. Like, just he's a really good healer. Exorcism utility is great. Healing utility is great, especially in one vision. If this was vanilla, he'd get put down a D. Because holy crap, healers are really bad in vanilla. But as far as one vision goes, healers are basically necessary in fights to get them. If your units don't have item utility on them, or item master, whatever the skill's called, on them to use the tier 2 rank healing items, you probably should have at least one healer on your map. Anyway, that's just what I've learned, that's just what I've observed in one vision. I think, yeah, definitely, because of one vision, he's going to be in A tier. I might actually just put him in S tier. Just because that's so important in one vision. You know what? Denalto, S tier. As far as healing goes. I think I would have put Rosa in S tier too if she was still a healer, but she's not, so let me move everyone to the side so that I can get everybody like fitted in here. Anyway, if you're wondering why the different portraits are different sizes, just what I can get from the wiki. So this is actually Ramos right here, but I'm using it to represent Bardolph. Next unit is Sarah's next, right? Yeah, Sarah's next. Okay, here's Sarah. Sarah does have her real colors on. Unfortunately, she does have weird things. Sarah! I think she would be above Palmia, honestly, just because... Actually, her traps are really good. Yeah, okay. The traps put her in A tier. Into A tier. Okay. Pull me up. Yeah, I mean, Sarah, traps, A tier. Those are really good. Traps are really fucking broken in this game. Especially, like, if you're using that one range, you can just push people's shields and, like, push them onto traps to do, like, half their HP in damage just for free. That's insanity. And again, I've just shown to you how you can abuse them to get, like, second turn finishers on your units with no danger to their health at all. I think I showed that off on the map with that really strong dragon. And like where we started at the top, it was like a copy of map 4. I don't remember which map that number that was, but it was a pretty recent map that I showed that off. Anyway, yeah, that's pretty much all I have explanation. Traps, really good. I guess she is a named rogue, but if there was like a rogue with a unique portrait, they would be an insane unit. Holy crap. I guess I could just make Denim a rogue, but I guess I could just make anybody a rogue and they would be crazy. Like, probably Aresia will be crazy, but I want her to use two-handed bows because she can. She has the ranks for it, so, you know. Anyway, moving on to... I just named him. Where is his portrait? Where is his portrait? I know I put him in here. There he is. He's at the bottom. Because V. Duh. Voltaire. You know what? If I put Reinhold in B, I had to put Voltaire in B too. So Voltaire, he's just like Reinhold. He's a very good tank. He's a better tank than Reinhold, does worse damage. But I did fix that a little bit, I think, by giving him an axe so he can flick breach on people and do more damage over time, especially to armored units. So, and he also has that, that ability that lets him take damage for other units that I've used to save units lives sometimes. So I think, you know what? Oh gosh. Can I see that? Yeah, okay. So I'm gonna definitely put him in A. I'm gonna put him up in A. You know what? Yeah. Just that ability to save other units, so like lives, so that they can heal or be healed, or like attack other units and kill the threat that's threatening them like that. I think that deserves an A, honestly. Yeah, that deserves an A from me. Okay, next freaking unit is Rose. So Rose is our first recruited unit off of the thing. Not our last, but our first. One of few, honestly. That's we've done, very few recruiting, because that's how it works. Rose, as far as she contributes, she kind of dies really often. She's not a good tank. I haven't been using her well. I know they buffed Terror Knights in the recent patches to be way better. Like, she can take, like, now Fearful Impact, if it hits, it will take away SP from foes, which is good. I really should think that should scale instead of being 60%. Maybe it scales up into, like, the enemy's resistance stat to where, so, but, like, frontline units that tend to have low resistance will get hit more often, and then will tend to have more TP, will get hit more often than, like, backline units that will have more resistance and don't get that V. I don't know if that's possible, but anyway, I think she's higher. She'd be higher than Bardolph, but I think I'm going to put her in D just to get high D, I think. Because she does do a lot of damage. She was, for a while there, her axe rank was really low because I had her on great swords, but now she's going to be using axes. She's decent at it now. Still doesn't have that rank 8, which is weird, like a lot of units do. I think she does have rank 2 dark though right now, and her dark magic still shit hits for shit. I can't hit it at all because of her low intelligence, but anyway, and I don't think I've been using her for that anyway. I really wish I could use her for that because that would be super useful, but maybe I'll train it or something and she'll be like, give her rank 8 dark magic and she'll be able to hit people with like a palsy and be able to stun and spread around stun, because stun is really good to spread around like that. It basically halves enemies' damage output over time, essentially, if you're lucky. Anyway, let's move on. Next unit, Penny. Penny's pretty good. I'll put her in C. Definitely really great for killing monster units. Not that they... there have been a couple of monster units that have been big threats. I wish she was available earlier in the game. She'd been available, her skills have been available earlier in the game, but those were things were more dangerous. And like I couldn't just eat through their health with like Denim or something. but still useful to eat through their health. They do have a lot of HP. It is useful to just, like, do a Beast Slayer finisher that does, like, 400 damage on them, and can, so that another unit can go in and finish them off. So definitely pretty freaking good. I'm just gonna put her in B. We'll see how the guns work out, but anyway, that's Penny. Next up, I don't remember actually. I think it's Ariseal. Is it Ariseal? Yeah, it's Ariseal. I hope I'm saying her name right. I know I was calling her Arcel earlier, but Ariseal's next. Yeah, she gets put up in A, I think. If not S. Her damage output is crazy against backline units. Like, the ability to traverse, I think I'm gonna put her in S. Like, as far as her role goes, she's like the epitome of an archer in this game. I think she's definitely the best an archer could get. Like, a backline unit that's meant to harass unit and spread around silence. I think that's her best, I think that's the best it could get in this game. In this game. No other unit can do what she does as far as spreading around silence to backline units, killing annoying backline units, and just doing enough damage to frontline units that are doing respectable damage to frontline units that may be like a little bit squishy. And if there's no like backline mages that I need to kill, she can spread around stunned, and she can also use Escalade to get into places that are, she can stand up. I don't think any of my other like ranged units can do that. No, Palmia can. Palmia can get escalated up, but I think she still deserves to be tier because of how squishy she is and her RT delay. Yeah, I think Ariseal deserves an S tier. And also because she'll be getting a really powerful bow soon. Although that shouldn't count for the tier list right now, since I'm doing a tier list off of like what their abilities are right now, but whatever. Okay, next unit is, who's number 14? Number 14 is Fulcourt. Where is Fulcourt? Come on down, Fulcourt. Fulcourt. I keep calling him Fulcourt, but it's Fulcourt. Anyway, Fulcourt is now a swords master. He's dual wielding one-handed swords and a one-handed katana. I think Fulcourt deserves an ace here. He does really good damage output. He blocks shit and dodges shit constantly. If he gets hit, he goes down pretty soon. But that's really only if magic mages hit him, and they don't tend to target him, I don't think. So yeah, he's pretty freaking good. I wonder if I should put anybody else out down into D tier, but I don't think I should. No, I don't think I should. Nah, I think that's good. Again, these tier lists are not ordered. I've already filled up half of A tier. Gosh, I'm gonna have to shrink some of these idiots down. Or just like bring it off the screen. Who cares? This is a shitty video anyway. A shitty video for a shitty channel. Next up is Bayon. Where are you, Bayon? Bayon's at the top. He starts with a B. Bayon. Like decent magic user. I think I'm gonna put him in B because he does a lot of damage with the summon against specific units. He's only ranked 3 water magic right now, which is real bad. Like I think he does, because he does such high damage, the way water scales, he just doesn't raise it high enough to be like, to get it high enough to like scale throughout the game. I mean, he can still hit fine, he still does decent damage, but you know, I think with the way like scaling works currently with as far as magic damage goes, it's just not great. I wonder if like ranks can fix that in the future. But like being rank 3 now isn't great, honestly, when I'm getting units that have rank 5. I think Kasha was like rank 6 now, but because of the way that stuff scales, going from rank 1 to rank 2 is significantly harder than going from rank 7 to rank 8, I think, in this game. So, like, you start to snowball as far as ranks go in the future. I know, because for one, you get a better hit rate as stuff goes up, so when you actually hit, you get more damage, and then number 2, you just do more damage, so that increases it more as well. Anyway, let's get on with it. What is next? Who the heck is next? That should be Sistina. Sistina, I'm not using her great. She does have an area move that always hits. That's pretty good. I'm gonna put her in low beads here. She's a geomancer. She does have an area move that always hits. He does cost 30 magic, so she can't use it immediately, but I haven't seen her die in a while, so I'm just gonna put her in B tier. low B tier because that's just she's good. I'm not very not happy for her to be on the map. Next up is Murden, I think. Really should have this. Yeah, Murden. Murden, right? Yeah, Murden. Okay. Where is Murden? I know I had his portrait all the way in here. Yep. Murden. Murdy, Murdy, Murdy. Dirty Murdy, I think. Dirty Murdy deserves a B tier. I don't think he's that great, honestly. He doesn't die very often. He does a lot of damage with his skills are really good, but as far as the unit he used, I think his niche is very crowded. As far as like a frontline kind of tanky damage dealer does, he's definitely better than Voltaire, but I don't use him for Voltaire's purposes. So I think one vision. I think they used to be basically better knights. They had the exact same skills as knights, but like more skills, so they were better versions of that. But white knights I'm talking about. But anyway, I think I'm gonna put him in B tier honestly because his skills. Like, as far as frontline damage dealers, I have plenty of those and plenty of those that do better dodge than he does. He does have the situation. I wish his exorcism move has two range. That might make it a little bit better, but it is really good when you can pull it off, but it's very situational, honestly. Especially when he's not against undead units, it's useless, of course, but against undead units, it's pretty good. Quicken is a really, really great buff. But anyway, I think a B tier is helpful for him. Next up, I think, is Adelaida, but let me check. Adelaida, where are you? Yeah, Adelaida. Okay, so I couldn't get a portrait. I didn't want to go in the game. I know how to extract portraits from the game, but I didn't want to go in and do it. So we're just gonna use the SNES artwork for fairies. Here you go. There's Adelaida. Adelaida. Oh, she's a healer. I think that has to be an A tier. Not as good as Donalto because she can't do exorcism at significant range, but yeah, I think that deserves an A tier just for healing utility. I think, yeah. Just like if she's not on the map, then the map is going to be significantly harder. Yeah. I'm gonna put her low A tier because I think her skills are bad, but and the instruments use is not great. Like it's really funny when it's funny when charm procs, and she is right too, so it's gonna proc more often, it's gonna hit more often. But as far as like the kisses skills aren't great. I really just need to take those off of her honestly and put something else on. But I think a low A tier is what she needs right now, so that's fitting that she's right there. But anyway, let's move on to another unit. I am not anywhere close to completing this. Holy crap, I'm really hungry too. I really should not have done this before lunch. Let's see, next unit is Chamos. Where is a ninja portrait? Okay, I have actually a boss portrait here that matches pretty closely. So ninja grenades, throwing stuff, throwing status around, pretty freaking good. A tier. I think that's all I have to say on that. I know a lot of units are in A tier, but I mean, one vision makes these units pretty good. He's made for it. He's really dodgy. He doesn't die very often. As when enemies hit them, target him. Enemies tend to actually not target him because they have low hit rates against him. Like the only enemies that target him are enemies with high hit rates, which are other rogues and stuff like that. So that's the only time I have to wait. I have to like worry about that damage. So yeah, that's all I have to say about him. Again, grenades are really, really freaking great. Utility and like his throwing weapons are really great too, and then he has a katana of course that he's ranking up just for shits and giggles. Next up is number 20 is Festa. I'm gonna put her in B tier because she's a better dragoon than Penny is right now. She's spears are really great. She's getting spear rank and she's already has rank 8 spears, and she has I think she has rank 8 spears. It might be rank 7 spears that she has. I haven't checked. I know she has all 4 finishers, but rank 7 spears. And she also has really high lightning rank, really high elemental rank for a unit that doesn't have magic. So I think she has rank 3 lightning, which is really great for a unit that doesn't use magic at all. Because I took magic off of her because it was so shit. But anyway, I think that's deserving of a B tier as far as doing damage goes. Because she also does really great damage to Dragon and Beast if I had Beast Slayer on her. which is really useful, especially against on maps where, if maps has like a one dragon, it's not really a threat, but maps with a lot of dragons are a threat, because eventually one or two of them are gonna start getting their finishers off, and it's just gonna be a fucking nightmare. Like again, with maps with one dragon, you can definitely like bring it down in one turn to where it can't use its finisher. But, or like, it's really, I'm just gonna call it its finisher because it costs 100 to get off and whatever. Okay, let's move on. Next up, Tmuz. This one I did have to extract from the thing. I do have a Raven Man portrait, but whatever. Tmuz, he dies kind of often. I'm gonna put it in C. I know flying is really great. Flying is really great. I'm gonna put him in B. Yeah. I think that's a low B for me. He dies pretty often. He's pretty squishy. He's meant to be like a really great damage dealer, as far as that goes. But he dies real often. More often than I like him to. Mostly because his mission is to kind of like go behind it. Because he's a flyer, he's gonna go behind enemy lines or places where I can't reach easily and start to wail on units. But that also gets him killed fairly often. Like I really wish he's a little bit more tanky maybe, and like a little bit less on the like class cannon side of things. Maybe more of a tank than anything else. But you know, and he's also really weak to magic, so enemies target him with magic the most and status the most often, which is really, really annoying. That's what inspired me to start putting wards on everybody. Anyway, let's get on with it. Okay, who's next? Next up is Hob. Where's he at? Hobberim. Hobberim's really, really good. Let's put him in A tier. Dodgy. Even more dodgy than Volcourt. Like, when if he gets unlucky, he will die. But, like, I think I've seen him block, like, more moves than I've seen him get hit by. Which is insane. I don't think I could say for any other unit. So I think I have to put him in A tier. As far as units go. I think that's all I have to say. Really great. Dancing utility is great. He has some of the ninja utility, not the grenades, which would make him, I think would bump him up to S tier, but, he is the decoy stuff, which is really, really great. I think, you know what, I think I'm comfortable putting him in S tier, honestly, for that kind of stuff. He's really great. Like, I could single-handedly put him out there, and he might, against multiple enemies, and he might just survive. Especially since he has a unique unique two-handed katana finisher, which heals, and he also has that two-handed katana use, which does that insane area damage, which is really great. I think I'm comfortable with putting an S here. Okay, next up is Antigone. I had to pull out a dragon portrait from the SNES days. I think Antigone goes in D. Dragons aren't great in this game, especially like for player dragons. Really, she doesn't do great damage. She's not as squishy as she was. I think she's a lot more survivable than she was, especially more than the Griffins. I think recently she's a lot more survivable, which pulls her out a little bit out of E tier. But she's, as far as getting hit by status, she just like Tmuz does. She attracts status, she kills stuff, and she attracts enemies' bullets, so that health goes away a lot, and she actually builds up TP for other units, and she doesn't actually build up much TP herself, unfortunately. So that's really bad. That's why she gets put in D's here. Anyway, let's move on. I've shit on Antigone enough. Next up is Devil. Oh-ee-o. Devil. Definitely not a D-tier unit. Okay, so I put him in Warden for now. Wardens, as far as his magic damage is actually not terrible. It's definitely better than Penny's or Festa's magic damage. I think Bertrand's too. I'm trying to think of where to put him. I don't think a C. I think I need to move more people out of B, but I think I'm putting him in B for now. As far as damage goes, it's pretty good. He has the instead of the instill. He has the area instill. I'm blanking what the name is of that move, but he has that for ice, which you can't put dark on wardens for some reason. I don't know why, but yeah, I guess because there are enough dark based classes anyway. You can put dark on Valkyries. I'm not sure why you can't put them on wardens, but whatever. Anyway, as soon as he gets like access to like songs and dances, that might be really fun to mess around with. But for now, B tier. Maybe as soon as he gets access to songs and dances, we can put him in A tier. But not here nor there. Okay, Pumpkin Trick is also really good. Pumpkin Strike's actually insane. You know what? High B tier for that. High B tier for Pumpkin Strike. Next up, that was 24, right? So next up should be Old Smelly Ass. Old Smelly Ass right here. Healer, S tier. S tier healer. I think she's the best healer. She's better healer than Nolto, honestly. So she would be the top, I think. I think Yolo would be the tippity top right there. Priest is a really great class for healing. And that's all I have to say. I explained how good healing's. She's just a better healer. She just has everything Dalto does and more. And she actually has some damage utility as well. And some unique finishers with guns. One unique finisher with a gun as well. But we'll see if I ever get that up. Okay, sorry about that. Next up, I did Old Smelly Ass. Who's 26? I think Olivia. There was a large space between units. It's like Devold and then Olivia. Because I think Olivia was Olivia chapter 4? Was it chapter 4 unit? Yeah, she was. Okay. Huh. That was a long space between units. I forgot about that. Olivia, where are you, Olivia? She right now. Olivia's not great. Again, she would be S tier if she was a healer right now, but she would be above Nolto. But right now, she's not doing great damage, honestly. I think, what trade did I put Bayon in? Do I really want to put her lower than Bayon? I think she does like a worse job than Bayon, so I have to put her tier lower than Bayon right now. Maybe when she gets higher ranked, she'll be a little bit better, but as far as like, Oracle is not a great class. I haven't been using it because I haven't had enough SP to use like the specials that they have. But I think I'm going to put her in C tier just because there's a lot of units that do stuff better. Okay. So, sorry I'm answering texts right now. I really shouldn't wish I didn't have to be doing that, but I'm already halfway through the episode, so, you know, I'm just going to do it. Next up, where I was already 37 minutes of this, and I'm, like, a little bit over halfway through. Well, no, I'm in C tier. I only have, like 10 units left. More than 10. Next unit is Surya. Where are you, Surya? I think wherever I put Sistina, she should be higher. I think she just has a bit more success than Sistina. Yeah, she would be higher B tier as opposed to Sistina's like mid B tier. I think they'd be right next to each other. So Sistina would be higher, or Surya would be higher than Sistina. Yeah, and I already explained what Sistina could do. So Surya could basically do the same thing. She just has great swords, so she has more damage output. And less blocking. She does almost the same blocking, honestly, but whatever. Enemies don't attack them, so, you know, don't have really much to say on that, on their tankiness or survivability, because enemies just don't attack them, they go for other units. Let's see. Who is next? Next up, I actually don't remember, is it? It's Elric. Elric actually hasn't appeared on a map in a while. I really need to get him into a map. But Elric, where did I put? Okay, this is gonna be flowing off in B tier. Elric is really good. Let me see if I can't float this a little bit to the side. Yeah, I can float these to the side. Let's float these a little bit to the side, hold on. Move them a little bit to the side so I don't have to float off just yet. Elric. Yeah, you can basically do what, I think he'd be a little bit more Reinhardt. So, like, as far as tankiness classes goes, Hoplites be at the top, Knights below them, and then Warriors below that, and then as you go down, it scales with how much damage output they have. So, like, Warriors have the best damage output, followed by Knights and then Hoplites, so basically that. He doesn't have any, like, stuff that can help out allies be defensive. He mostly has stuff that can help himself be defensive. So, as far as I can tell, not great, which is why he goes into B tier while Voltaire goes into A tier. As far as like defense goes, because Voltaire could just take punishment from other units to himself, which is really great, and Elric just has standard tanking utilities. Next up is. Let's do a silly voice so we don't have to do anything else. Next up is Sherry. Sherry in the same boat as Olivia. I think she's slightly better than Olivia right now because she has more casting experience, so she has like higher rank in Earth, I think. But I think she's just in the same boat as where she's not doing a great damage. I really don't think I'm using... I really think I'm using these classes wrong, but I don't think she's appeared on the map in a while, so maybe I just have bad memories of what she's doing. Hold on once. Still answering texts. Next, where was I? Oh, we were on Sherry. Next up is number 30 is Kashua. Kashua goes into S tier along with the other healers. She doesn't have good healing utility, but she has good combat utility. So I think that bumps her back up. That would bump her to A tier, and then the good combat utility bumps her back up to S tier. I don't think I'm going to rate her as high as Aurelius, and maybe like tied for Denalto as far as healing goes, as far as like healer goes. But yeah. That's all the healers rated. That's pretty cool. I don't think, yeah, and that's like Arbiter's really funny. Arbiter's not really great. Conviction's pretty good. Not as good as Deneb's, but it probably shouldn't be. I'd appreciate like one more range on it. Because its TP is already so high anyway. I know she's supposed to be like a frontline person. She's supposed to be tanking in the like kind of in the front line, maybe in the mid line, so she can get a little bit more SP. But anyway, that's about it for Kashua. Let's see, we're moving down to the final row. Next up is... Where is he? Lindell! Lindell's an A tier, I think, for me. So good damage output, access to grenades, enough freaking said. Lindell. Can I move any of these to the side? Yeah, I can move you to the side a little bit. Just do that. Sorry, it's snapping real bad right now, so... Moved to the side. I'm almost done, but anyway. Okay. Enough said. I think I explained. I already gushed about grenades enough, and Lindell's just a better grenade user. So, next up is. Poggamp. Where's Poggamp? I know I saw him earlier because I was confused. Poggamp. I think B tier. I think B tier is free. This is pretty good for him. Does good damage with his whip. Has good range with his whip. Has the ability to support the beasts, and is the only reason like beasts are out of F tier, honestly. So I'm gonna put Gamp in B tier. As far as unit support goes, he's pretty good. And yeah, he has decent. He has good finishers. Whips. He's the only character I have that uses using whips right now. So I think that puts him into B tier. Good freaking logic. Whatever, I just feel like he's a beast here, you know? Okay, next up, both flying beasts, Birda and Opta, Cockatrice and Griffin, respectively, because I cheated and made Birda, Griffin, Cockatrice. I'm just going to use Griffin for both of them. I don't think anybody's truly F tier, but I'm going to put them both in E tier. They're just big pain in my sides. More than Antigone is, definitely more than Antigone is, but... Still kind of a pain in the ass to keep alive. They definitely, I think I'm, like, you can make an argument for one healer if they're not on the map, but considering they have, like, more chance to be on the map than any other unit, because they're lower level, and I, like, put them on the map because to get them levels, and then they die, and then I'm like, oh, they're not going to get any levels, oh no. Just pain in the butt. Oh my god. And these, I think I'm just using them badly, but, you know. Who's next? Sorry, I got distracted again. Who's next? I stand for Azelstan. Where the fuck is Azelstan? I know I saw him because I checked all of this before. Hand. There he is. Azelstan. We stand for Azelstan. I think. Does Azelstan deserve an A tier? I think he deserves an A tier. Probably not an S tier, but A tier I think is good. I think an A tier is good, yeah. Yeah. Again, really great ranged utility with guns. He does amazing damage with knives. I think if he had swords, he would do even better damage, or like, God forbid he had like a hammer or an axe. I don't even know if he could wield those things, but I just gave him daggers because no one else is using daggers, and I want to spread out my weapon usage. But, and there's also like a really good water dagger. I think it's like second highest or something, but... Yeah, I'm keep getting distracted. Just like my texts are blowing up right now. I didn't expect this to happen while I was recording. So, and but I can't stop now because it happened like halfway through recording, and you know. But next up is where is she? There she is. Deneb, S tier, easy S tier. She does absolutely insane damage. Even though she's squishy, I don't think she's even squishy as unit. No, she's probably a squishy as unit. I've scratched that. Definitely the squishy as unit in my head. But holy shit, she takes Glass Cannon to another level. I don't think I even have to explain it. Just freaking watch the series. Anytime she's on the map, she's going to end up probably one-shotting a unit with a summon. Anyway, next up, I don't know why my door's open. But... oh god, my door has been open this whole time. I've been yelling. Hold on 1 second. Okay, okay, I'm sorry about this. I'm probably not gonna even edit these out because this needs to go up today. So, this is gonna be like raw and extreme. Janna, this is actually Zatobaba's portrait, but we're just gonna use of Janna because I feel like getting another one. Janna, I think goes in C tier as well. I think there's units that do better. Like, I think Band does a better job at doing area and being like a caster, and I think she might be above the sisters because of too close to the mic. Because of the Ivory Tower. The fact that she could just negate all damage on her every turn, but she also loses access to meditate, which is a huge blow. Yeah, like at least the sisters have meditate. Yeah, that might put her below the sisters, honestly. Just to get losing access to meditate. So she has to be, like, magic leafed up at all times. But anyway, that's here. And as far as the last unit goes, we have Rudlum. I think if I put... oh, God, do I put him in B? Nah, let's put him in C tier. I might be using Warlocks wrong. I think Warlocks are bad. I think he'd be at the top of C tier, honestly. Maybe below Penny or something, or, like, Bertrand. But he'd be at somewhere closer to the top of C tier, but... I don't think he's doing well. No, he does have high, like, ranks, but you saw, like, crap damage he was doing with his area finishers, like, during that one map. Like, it was bad. At least that's what I remember about it. But he does decent damage with Rhyme, and he passes around MP, so I think that keeps him in a D tier. Like, that definitely, like, he's not that bad. He's not as bad as, like, the people in D tier. Yeah, so that'll be it for Tactics Ogre. I think a lot of units are closer to B. Which, you know, maybe I should move some units down, like, kind of consolidate it towards C. But I think I kept enough units out of S tier and put enough units in A tier for this to be considered a decent tier list as far as balancing goes. Anyway, that'll be it for this one. That'll be it for this Tactics Ogre tier list? Like... Dcapit8ed Let's Play Tactics Ogre tier list. Anyway, that's been it. Thank you for watching. This has been... I do enjoy doing tier lists, but holy shit, this one went on for 50 fucking minutes. Really shouldn't have done that. Did I just black out during the middle of this? Or do I really just, like, rant on about units? Granted, I did review, like, 39 units. This map is... this is going way too long. I need to get lunch. I'm so hungry. Holy crap. Thank you for watching. See ya.